The Shoemaker's Holiday by Thomas Dekker. Characters, Summary and Analysis. Hello and welcome to The Discourse. Thomas Dekker was one of the prominent dramatists and pamphleteers of the Jacobean age of English literature. He got engaged in a creative tussle against Ben Jonson, who ridiculed Dekker in his play Poester as Demetrius Phanius and as Aeneas in Cynthia's Rebels. Their rivalry contributed to the War of Theatres in 1600 and 1601. Thomas Dekker reposted against Jonson in his play Satyromastics, in which he ridiculed Jonson as an affected hypocritical Horace. His most famous playwright is The Shoemaker's Holiday, which is a romantic city comedy. The Shoemaker Holiday presents the conflict of classes and showcases the strengthening of the middle class during the Jacobean and Caroline era. The play is based on the real-life story of a merchant who rose to prominence during the 15th century. Simon Eyre, from 1395 to 1458, was a London merchant and artisan who later became the Lord Mayor of London in 1445. In The Shoemaker's Holiday, Dekker depicts Simon Eyre as a shoemaker who rises up to become the Mayor of London and gains the trust and favor of the king. The play is set in the reign of King Henry IV, depicting the period of war against France. Characters of The Shoemaker's Holiday. Roland Lacy is the nephew of Sir Hugh Lacy, who is the Earl of Lincoln. He is in love with Rose Oatley, the daughter of Sir Roger Oatley, the Lord Mayor of London. Roland disguises himself as Hans Melter. As there is a huge class difference between them, Rose's father rejects their relationship. However, Roland Lacy and Rose are adamant to live together. Askew is Roland's cousin. Simon Eyre is a master shoemaker for whom Ralph works. Ralph is the husband of beautiful Jane. He is drafted to the war against the French army. Sybil is maid of Jane. Hammond is a wealthy London citizen who tries to woo and seduce Jane in absence of Ralph. The king appears in the end to solve the issues. Summary of The Shoemaker's Holiday. Rose Oatley and Roland Lacy are deeply in love and want to marry. However, Sir Hugh Lacy, uncle of Roland, doesn't agree with the relationship because of the class difference between the two families. He vows to stop Roland from marrying Rose, the poor middle class girl. He deliberately sends a command to his nephew to join Prince Henry V, who is preparing to invade France. However, Roland avoids going to war by turning the command to his cousin Askew, and he himself disguises as a Dutch shoemaker Hans Melter and joins Simon Eyre, a master shoemaker. Sir Roger Oatley is not against the marriage of Rose and Roland, but to avoid ignominy, he confines his daughter at his home in London. Simon Eyre has another apprentice and journeyman named Ralph Dampert, who recently got married to a beautiful girl, Jane Dampert. Ralph has also been drafted into the war. Simon Eyre is a famous shoemaker and he serves the king and other noblemen. He tries to convince officials to allow Ralph to stay home with his new bride. But Simon fails and Ralph is forced to go to the war. Before going to the war, Ralph gifts a pair of shoes to Jane that he made for her. After some time, when Jane hears no news about Ralph, she starts fearing that he might have been killed in the battleground. Jane leaves the Eyre house with her maid Sybil and starts living with Rose in the mayor's house. Meanwhile, Hammond, a wealthy London citizen, goes hunting in Lord Mayor's estate with his assistant Warner. While hunting, Hammond and Warner see Rose, Jane and Sybil in the estate. Hammond immediately falls in love with Jane while Warner loses his heart for Sybil. Hammond proposes to Jane, but Jane refuses him, as she says that she is still waiting for Ralph to return. However, Hammond is adamant to get Jane's love. So Jane says that if it is proven that Ralph will never return or he is dead, she may think of remarriage, and if that happens, she will marry Hammond. At Simon's house, Roland, disguised as Hans, succeeds in speculating the valuables of an unclaimed ship in the cargo, which allows Simon to earn huge profits. Simon uses this money to gain social prominence and is made an alderman. He further strengthens his grip in the political circle. One of the servants of Sir Hugh Lacy informs him that Roland is not at the battleground in France. Sir Hugh sends his servant to know the whereabouts of Roland. Rose also comes to know that Roland has disguised as Hans, the shoemaker, who is living in London, and the two lovers start meeting again and decide to marry as soon as possible. Initially, Sir Hugh Lacey was opposing the marriage because of the high status of the Lacey family. But now, Sir Otley is against the marriage as he thinks that now his daughter is trying to marry a shoemaker, someone much lower than his class. When Sir Hugh learns that Rose is marrying the shoemaker, he gloats that this middle-class girl will never be able to marry his nephew. But soon he realizes that Hans, the shoemaker, is actually his own nephew Roland, and thus he also vows to stop their marriage at any cost. Meanwhile, Hammond devises a plan to marry Jane. He forges some official papers to show Ralph's name on the dead soldier's list. When Jane sees Ralph's name on the dead soldier's list, she is saddened but relents and agrees to marry Hammond. At the same time, Ralph, who was wounded in the war, manages to return to London. When he comes to know that Jane has already left Simon's house, he tries to know her whereabouts. He comes to know that Jane is going to marry Hammond soon. He goes to intercept the marriage and confronts Jane. When Jane sees Ralph and realizes that he is still alive, she becomes very happy and Hammond's plan to get her fails. Hammond tries to bribe Ralph with money and tells him to leave Jane and let her marry him. However, Ralph rejects the bribe and chides Hammond. Hammond relents gracefully and lets Jane go with Ralph. Roland and Rose decide to marry on the same day. Sir Otley and Sir Hugh both unite together to stop the marriage, but the young couple outfoxes both of them and gets married. Sir Hugh and Sir Otley charge Roland of treason for deliberately avoiding the draft to go to the war. Later on, Simon Eyre wins the election and is made the new Lord Mayor of London. His reputation goes so high that the king himself decides to come and dine with him. During the dinner, Simon asks the king to bless Roland and Rose. He asks the king to pardon Roland and let the young lovers cherish their life. On the other hand, Sir Otley and Sir Hugh ask the king to annul the marriage of Roland and Rose. The king listens to the parents and annuls the marriage. However, soon he calls the couple up and announces their remarriage again. He offers knighthood to Roland. The king blesses Roland and Rose and the play ends. As the king says, love respects no blood, cares not for birth or state. Thomas Dekker used Thomas Delaney's The Gentle Craft as the main source for the story of his drama. He represents the tensions between the social classes of London in this play and gives prominence to the lower artisan class. Dekker also accuses sexism and opposes the tendency of men to consider women as an asset that they can buy. Hammond tries to buy Jane's love in Ralph's absence with his wealth. Again, when Ralph returns, he tries to buy Jane by bribing Ralph, to which Ralph refuses and chides him. So this was all about the Shoemaker's Holiday. We will continue to discuss the Jacobean and Caroline age of English literature. Please stay connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.